pluck the G string, an open G, with the thumb of your right hand. And then you'll be hammering on your first finger of your left hand. Going up chromatically, then do the same. Then you'll be pulling off. Just do that over and over again and build up the speed for that also. In this section, we're going to be talking about the major scale. This is going to be the G major or E minor scale. I'm going to show you seven different positions you can use. Now, I'm starting out with the right hand, so the first note you're going to hear is going to be higher than the one you hear with the left hand, okay? So this is the first position. Second position. Third position. Position. Fifth position. Then sixth position. And the seventh position. Okay, now I'm going to show you a lick that combines all of those positions I just showed you. Okay, from the one that we ended up on, back down to the one that we started on. Okay, you can have a pick in your hand for this one. What you'll do is pick the first note, and then you'll do, the rest will be all hammering. Okay, so it'll go like this. Down to the second string. Down to the third string. Down to the fourth string. Down to the fifth string. Sliding up to a D note. Okay, all together that'll sound like this. Okay. Now this next lick, I'm going to play it, this has got more of a linear approach to it. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to hammer on to the 7th fret on the 3rd string with the 1st finger of my right hand. Slide that up to the top of the neck, pull off to the 1st finger of my left hand, then hammer on to these notes. Then pull my left hand back around, then my right hand goes over the top. Then my left hand. Okay, then. Okay, so all together it's going to sound like this. Mm-hmm. In this section, we're going to go on to triads. Okay, a triad is like a three-note chord. What you can use these for is to enhance, you know, chordal sounds that you have. Okay, like if you have a chordal pattern going from major to minor or whatever, you can take these triads and overlay them on the top, and it can really give out a really nice, pretty sound. Now, what you do with your left hand is you're going to hold that chord cluster, that triad cluster, like this. This is going to be a G major here. Like this, okay? Now, with your right hand, you're going to be playing the next one on top, which is also a G major. See? Okay, and then go up to left hand will now be playing what the right hand was playing, and your right hand will be up on this one. Okay, now your left hand will be playing what the right hand was playing, and your right hand will be playing what your left hand was playing on the first position. Okay, now I just showed you those triads, G triads, on the first, second, and third strings. Now let's go on to the second, third, and fourth strings, and I'll show you these triads. Okay, same thing, G major. This is a shape the left hand will be playing, and on top of it. Okay, then move the left hand up to where the right hand was, and play this on top of it. Then move your left hand up to where the right hand was, and play this on top of it. Okay, now let's do minor. Start on the third fret. Okay, this is what we have. Okay, now move your left hand up, and this is what you'll have. Okay. That'll be the top one. Okay, let's go on to the next, the second, third, and fourth strings here. Okay, this is the way it'll sound for this one. Okay, then move your left hand up, and your right hand will be playing this. Then move your left hand to what your right hand was playing, and use your right hand for this. Now what you can do is you can take these different ideas here. Like you can go from, like say we're going to start off with a G major, okay? Then we're going to go to a D major, okay? Then we're going to go up to an A minor. Back to a G major. See, there's all kinds of different, you can do this with any chord progression. It'll work with any chord progression. And just follow it in time like that with the chord progression. It can really enhance the sound. Okay, that was another triad idea right there. What I'm doing here is I'm playing part of the triad with my left hand, and then the other part with the right hand on top of it. This goes over an E major chord. Now the same shape is going to go, you play it straight down, a fourth down, on the second and fourth string instead of the first and third. Okay, so now we're going to have, and then for the D, we just move it down to, we're on the first and third strings again. And for the A, it's the second and fourth strings, like that. So I'm playing it in a sequence. For each pattern, I'm playing it four times. See, I've got the fifth, root, and major third right there. Okay, so that the same thing applies to all the other three chords also. Okay, now what you can do is you can take what your right hand was playing and play it with your left hand, and if you had that first one recorded on a track, you can put this one over the top of it and you'll be harmonizing yourself, okay? So this is the way it'll go. You'll be playing the root, major third, and fifth, okay? Then down to the D and the A. So it's E, B, D, A for the chords again, okay? Another idea you can use here, the same type of idea is a triad thing. What you can do is take like the G shape, just two notes, okay? First finger on the 7th fret, second finger on the 2nd string, 8th fret. Okay, now you'd be playing, so you got the 5th root, then you'll have the root and the major 3rd here. Now what I'm going to be playing, it'll be a G to a G sus, okay? So it'll be like this. That's for the G, and then for the G sus, I'm going up to the major 2nd right here, and I'm playing the sus 4 right here. Back to the G. Then go down to an F chord, to an F and an F sus, okay? Together that'll sound like this. Okay. Okay, in this section, this is incorporated examples. These are some solos that I've laid down on record. The first one that I'm going to be playing is from the album Sign In Please, and it's a song called Fridays, okay? After I play along with the tape, then I'll break it down for you and I'll show you what I've done. And it goes like this. Okay, now this is what I've done on that. On the first hammer-on part there, what I'm playing is I'm hitting an A with the first finger of my right hand, and then I'm pulling immediately off to a G. This is all on the 3rd string here. Okay, then I'm going... See, I'm doing that very fast though. Then I'm hitting the A again, sliding up to the top of the neck, pulling off to the 2nd finger, sliding that up. Once that 2nd finger gets to the top, then I have my 1st finger already down on the next note, which is an F sharp. Then I pull that off to that. Okay, then I slide that up. Pull it off to an E, D, C, D, A. Okay, so you can actually use a pick for this section also. You can have a pick in your hand while you're doing all this part. Okay, then you go right into the hammer-on part. Now what I did for this is I put the pick in my mouth, or else I just throw it away, whatever. And I go right into doing the octaves, okay? The octaves, the first one is over a G major chord. So what I'm playing here is with the right hand we'll be playing the root G octaves. Okay? The left hand will be playing D, which is the 5th of G. Okay, so it goes like this. I'm gonna be playing that part 8 times. One. Okay, now the next chord I go to is a D major chord. Well, I've already got a D with my left hand, so I don't have to move that. So what I do is I move the G down just a half a step, and I've got the major 3rd of D, okay? So it's going from G,